Hi, Bamboo. This is Carlos Felipe, and this is another episode of your Advisor for Life. Today, we are very privileged because we are going to talk to a distinguished guest with us today. He is a motivational speaker and a body language expert. He was one of our plenary speakers during the Asia-Pacific Life Insurance Congress held in Genting Highlands. So let us welcome Mr. Christian Chua.
Thank you for accommodating our little chat
for this afternoon. So, first question is this. One of the major hindrances that we as agents, life insurance agents have, is what we call the fear of approaching clients, or call reluctance in our language. So, fear of approaching prospects due to maybe lack of confidence in the product, in our industry, or in ourselves. How do you think we as agents could cope up with this?
Okay, so there's always two parts to this. One is what you mentioned, they're not well versed in the product. And just like a public speaker, why do people get stage fright? Because they are afraid that the audience will judge them. So I tell public speakers to be very, very well versed in their content. You have no problem speaking to children because the children is not going to judge you. But you have problems speaking to someone that's smarter than you. So in the same way, if agents want to overcome that, they need to be very well versed in their product at the tip of their hands. And if it's possible, know more than what the industry requires them to. Learn about other kinds of investment outside the industry. So that makes them really ready for it. So the other one is this inner behavior. They are low on resistance and they're low on resilience, and they get they're very sensitive when they face rejection. They really need to psycho themselves. What's the worst case scenario? People's gonna say no. Once I had a dentist and he came to me and said, I really like the other female doctor, but I'm afraid she'll say no if I ask her out. And I said, what's the worst case scenario? And he said, she's gonna reject me. I said, right? And what's the best case scenario? She's gonna say yes. I said, no, she's gonna say yes, she's gonna fall in love with you, you're gonna get married, you're gonna have her children. So the upside potential is so high, but the downside potential is so low. So in the same way, just ask the client, and if he says no, just no. If he says yes, maybe he's going to be a ginormous client for you. It's a very soft inner voice, that unconscious voice that keeps telling you something. And you believe that voice. Carlos, the guy's going to reject you. Carlos, you're not going to be successful. You need to change that voice. That self-talk.